Alright, what's going on everybody? How are we doing today? Steve Minglecoat, Final Web Design, and in today's video I want to talk about why coding in today's marketplace is just not enough for the job market. So let's get into it. Final Web Design, this is Steve. So basically guys, if you've been in the coding industry for the last several years as I have, I've been in it since about 2008, 2009 now, and you have seen it really change a lot. Coding these days is just not enough to be a good employee in today's marketplace. You've seen big companies like Twitter laying off 80% of their tech department. You've seen companies like Microsoft, Meta, Google, Airbnb, Uber, the list goes on. And basically what's been happening is that coding these days is simply just not enough for the marketplace. I have worked with big, large corporations, such as healthcare, such as universities, that you were working on teams of people building one web application or one website. And honestly, it was pathetic to say the least. I mean, there was a lot of days where we didn't do anything, or at least I didn't. I don't know what everybody else did, but applications and websites just don't take that many people to build, even big applications. Now, if you're working on some unique special features like, you know, maps or, payment gateways, or there are things, but for the majority of that technology now, there's already some type of third-party software, plugin, extension, code base, GitHub repo that you can go to grab that code and use it for your projects or your corporation's projects. Now, I think a lot of this was coming from the fact that upper management and stuff, when you get in these positions, they honestly, a lot of times, are not that familiar with how this stuff works. I don't know how a lot of these people get into these upper lead management roles for some of these corporations and companies, but a lot of them don't have the tech skills that they're hiring people like us for to go in and build these software and build these applications. This goes to my situation at United Healthcare, which is really Optum. Hopefully I can just say that out there, but I mean, we had a team of people in New York, in Minneapolis, in Chicago, in California, that were all working on these applications every day. And I remember my part of the application was I was basically doing a hero section, which is like as you come into a website that had a slider. And I gotta say, I think they gave us like 6 weeks to build this thing. And I mean, it's absolutely ridiculous because something like that can be built in half a day if you know what you're doing, if you know what to do. Now, yeah, you might want to have an extra couple of days to play with it, test it, incorporate it into the other components people are building. But this wasn't a complicated feature that required this much time. And you have to remember, these are really good salaries. I mean, we're talking $40, $50 an hour type jobs. And it just got to a point where I was like, this is like kind of a little bit crazy. I don't think that the management or the people who are building or want requesting these applications fully understand what they're asking for. So I think that the world and time has kind of caught up to that because technology is not as new now. So a lot of people and businesses have kind of caught on to that. I know that was a big thing when Elon Musk bought Twitter, now X. Right away there were layoffs, and basically you could see, because I was watching people in YouTube and stuff that were internal within Twitter, and you could see a lot of them knew that Elon knew how to code, that he knew JavaScript and frameworks and TypeScripts and all these technologies, and he knew he didn't need a office building full of people to run an application like Twitter in 2020. And I think that's where kind of the world's gotten to now, is that we all kind of realize that this stuff isn't that hard. I have a client who actually asked for a like TikTok application similar. And if you really have done your research and stuff, you know that out there on the marketplace, there are a lot of TikTok type applications available that can be built from GitHub repos. Now, yes, you have to customize it. Yes, you want to add your own features. yes, you want to brand it and bring your own logos and pictures and, you know, it's not like you could just take it and be like, oh, this is another TikTok. No. But there are pieces of it that if you know what you're doing can be utilized and going forward. So coding these days is just not enough. Not only is it not enough, it's gotten to kind of be a little bit boring. Back in the day, coding was cool. Coding was fun. But like, what are you really going to do with your code these days? Most, again, of these systems and softwares and technologies are out there and they're available on some type of repo or some type of purchase through a third party. It's gotten to a point where you need to be developing other skills. Now, what are these other skills? They're soft skills. They're business skills. They're sales skills. They're communication skills. They're teamwork skills. They're being a good customer service skills. That's huge these days. And far too many people don't want to take the time to kind of bridge this gap between being a tech person and a coding person and being a business, you know, understanding how business works, understanding how to grow a company from a digital perspective. This gets into social medias, this gets into Google Ads, this gets into video and YouTubes, and, you know, the list goes on. But you really have to start to bridge these gaps that nowadays coding is not the do-all, say-all. It's not going to be that way. That phase has ended, and you can see it with the job market. You can see it with the amount of employees moving from positions to positions now. I will say, even just maybe 5 years ago, you could get a job almost anywhere in the tech field. There were so many people looking for jobs, so many employees looking for tech people to work those jobs. And it was insane. You put out a resume and like six people would hit you back like, hey, you know, we got an appointment ready to set you up for the test and the meeting or whatever the situation was. A lot of times, even when people were given those tests and exams, I'd just be like, you know what, I don't have half a day to sit here and do your project or your exam. If you want to give me the job, hey, I'm there. I'll be there ready to go. I'll get this thing done for you. But I'm not going to sit here, spend half a day doing some coding brochure, going through, you know, five or six different interview processes to get a job that I can just go to the next person who's just dying to get somebody there that knows what they're doing. And that's the thing. If you know what you're doing, that's a big thing. But pretty much within a first week or first month of a job, you're going to find that they're going to know right away whether you can do this or not. And you can't really lie your way through a tech role. And so with coding kind of being in the back burner, really get yourself more involved. Understand HTML, understand CSS, understand JavaScript, understand frameworks, understand CMSs like WordPress and Drupals, but also work on the soft skills of just being a good business person, being a good employee, being a good, you know, communicator. These things are becoming more and more important, and it's going to continue to go that way because we just don't need 8 hour a day somebody sitting there building some type of website. It's not feasible. You have to merge these skills with other skills to make yourself very valuable for where things are at and where things are going in the future. With that being said, don't get down on this industry. It's still the best industry you can be in. There are so many benefits, whether you want to have some type of freedom with your roles as far as being in the office, being out of the office. You want to have a lot of opportunity out there still. You want to continue to learn and grow. All these things come together to make this one of the best opportunities and one of the best jobs out there. However, the actual coding and building an application yourself and just sitting there working all 9 to 5 on one website or one application, those days are done. They are absolutely done, and it's not coming back. So with that being said, guys, I hope this video doesn't like bring down the position, because I think that this is actually a good thing. Who really wants to be that person with three screens, you know, with one going vertical so that you can sit there and, you know, code your lines and push it up to the servers and push it up to the repos. That's just, it's past that stage. We've evolved. Those things are still there. They're still needed, but you're gonna have to learn how to build yourself as a business, as a business person, and what your skills can use to help the other company or your company grow or help your employer grow. So with that being said, guys, I hope this video helps. If you enjoyed it, a like, a subscribe. That stuff helps us, and we'll catch you in the next one. Peace.